Breaking news this morning, the House, which was said that it was going to vote on DC statehood, has apparently voted in support of DC statehood. That is what my team is telling me. For the Democrats in the House to do so is, I don't know, Bridget, is it surprising? It feels like I'm always ready to be disappointed, but what do you think?
I'm so happy this has happened. I live in DC. I was born here. If I could turn my camera around, I won't because my apartment's very messy, but I have a DC flag hanging from on my wall. So I'm very excited with this. This was expected, at least in my perspective. I think the real hurdle will be in the Senate. But I want to say, like, we have never been closer to DC statehood ever in my lifetime. For me, this is one of the biggest racial justice and civil justice issues of our time, that we are closer than ever to actually making a difference on it. And so I am so hopeful that DC will be the 51st state in my lifetime. I gotta warn y'all, if it actually does happen while I'm living in DC, the bender that I will go on to celebrate will be like epic. But I genuinely do think, you know, it is high time that the citizens of DC, we have been disenfranchised for so long. And I think, you know, it is high time that we have the kind of representation that the rest of the country gets. It's immoral, it's racist, it's so terrible that we have not gotten it. But I am so optimistic. I loved seeing this news today. And I think we are closer than we ever have been to DC statehood. I'm so excited.
Yeah. Close. We'll have to see. I mean, Biden says he's in support of it. I have this pit in my stomach thinking about some particular senators that we've been focusing a lot on the show recently, actually, who are gonna almost certainly stand against it. The right is already complaining. I can't imagine the collective meltdown that they would have if, you know, Americans got representation. Like, they don't want people voting in areas where they can technically vote. They certainly don't want them voting in areas where they can't yet. And the argument we've responded to a couple times, but I'd like to hear your thoughts, is the Dems just want to do it because they know that DC is going to vote for them. What do you make of that argument as a reason not to do DC statehood?
I mean, it's completely stupid. It makes no sense. People, the citizens of DC deserve voting representation. It's immoral that we don't have it. If the Republicans are really this concerned about which way we're going to vote, maybe they should try having better policies, policies that make people actually want to vote for them if that's what they're so concerned about.
Mm-hmm.
I think
So you're implying that politicians could try to appeal to people.
Yeah, I mean, it's a thought. it's an idea.
It's just so pathetic. This surrender, like, there's no way. We've got nothing. I look out at you, DC, and I know there's nothing I could say or do, or that my donors would let me say or do that would ever appeal to you. So I will block you from being represented. It's such a pathetic surrender. But that's what they've got.
Some of the things they say about DC, you know, oh, DC doesn't have a car dealership. Never mind the fact that we do, you know, DC, you know, there aren't loggers that work in DC. People who live in DC aren't real Americans. It's funny because when I pay my taxes, they certainly cash my real check and take my real money out of my real bank accounts. So it's really funny how we become not real Americans when we're talking about whether or not DC residents deserve statehood.
I had not heard the logger thing. I had heard the car dealership thing. Yeah, and you had Representative Mace saying it's too small, even though multiple states are smaller. There was some other Republican chucklehead who was like, no, they don't deserve to be a state because they're filled with criminals. And I thought, well, you can make the problem a little bit better by retiring. Get out of DC and it'll be one person closer to paradise. But anyway, yeah, we'd never let a place with crime. Look at Florida. It's not even that they just have a lot of criminals. They have the weirdest, kookiest criminals. They still get to vote. Anyway, it's BS. But I'm glad in particular that it happened on a day when you're with us to give your impression.
Me too. Yeah. So excited.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.